The Red Wings, meanwhile, had started the season with a record of 22-3-1-1 in their first 27 games and never looked back. GM Ken Holland had kept the nucleus of the cup-winning team of the late 90s together, with the biggest change being in goal. Now, Dominik Hasek was the starting goaltender. Vancouver had been among the league's best teams since mid-December. The Canucks had been in last place in the Northwest Division on Boxing Day, but exploded after that, posting a record of 28-9-3-1 afterwards. They'd finished with 94 points, their highest total since 1992-93.
Broken up for the breakaway. Here's Yuri Fischer. Fischer in, scores! The defenseman, Yuri Fischer.
And it's Yuri Fischer and Todd Bertuzzi.
Fired in by Fischer.
Look out.
Bruce Putt, they score! Came right up front, Brett Hall, and that's just the break the Red Wings were looking for.
Look at this.
Maltby was tied up with Bertuzzi. Naslund's quick shot is blocked by a sliding Larionov. And the puck is loose. Another turnover. Gets through to Bertuzzi. Backhander stopped by Hasek. And they bang away at it. The red light goes off. But the referee immediately signals no goal.
Things heating up in front of the net as well.
Couturier made the stop there. From the side of the net. Shanahan one time. Stop! Rebound! Might have hit the outside of the net. Here's Hall. Couldn't get the first one away quickly. Holmstrom. Worked with Brian Helmer. Centering feed. Shots! No! Off the crossbar. Looked like it went up and in over Couturier. And the immediate indication was no goal. Holmstrom, big hit on the far side. As opposed to, say, Dominik Hasek, who could really focus on that big line, which just applied the big hit. Race for the puck. Larionov gets there. Even Larionov shot. And Couturier the save. Maltby, good check on the far side. Puck kept in. Big save, Couturier. And rebound. Stopped by Couturier, and it dribbled wide. Kirk Maltby, the backhanded effort.
Boy, Couturier looks good.
Ooh, they also made it to the finals against the New York team. Shot from the side of it, and big stop by Hasek.
He's got two young children, and it means the world to him to go home. And when he's home, he's not a hockey player anymore. He's just a dad. And he says it's really improved his demeanor and his preparation and the disappointments of not playing well. Oh, Maltby and Bertuzzi.
Maltby and Bertuzzi before they drop the puck. Detroit does not have the Darian Hatcher type of player. Blake.
Nope.
A big size, not just a big size guy, but a big size guy who plays half the game. A Chris Pronger, those kinds of players.
Vladimir Konstantinov.
Exactly. Turnover. Rovitai backhand forehand score. Luke Rovitai, and the Red Wings lead 1-0. Tried the tricky pass to Naslund, it didn't work. Here's Fischer leading the charge. Long shot, testing Couturier. That's a great idea, the long shot. And the 265th consecutive sellout. Wow, Fischer is wrecked in the corner. Hit there by Todd Warner. Kept in by Vancouver. Floater missed the mark. Here's Cook. Try to go back door, and they score! What a pass by Cook! And the Canucks have tied it at one, had Hasek moving.
What a play, though, to begin it. Warner absolutely drilled. Yuri Fischer.
Here's Yzerman now. He's got a step. Yzerman, wrist shot, got it away. And Couturier to save.
Puck's gone!
Hall will pick up a loose puck. Toll the center, went off Olin, skate, and then off the crossbar. Hall lets it go. Couturier will save that one and hang on. Wild scramble. In the Vancouver end. The shot never made it on goal. Bertuzzi's out. Back to five aside. Loose puck, scramble for it. Couturier's got it. And there's the whistle as bodies go flying. And a penalty coming up.
Holding the puck, actually.
Closing his hand on the puck. Lidstrom. His pass for Rovitai. Took the hit from Cook. Gets it across. Lidstrom fakes the shot. Gets the return feed. Here's Fedorov, shot, score! Sergei Fedorov off the crossbar and in! And
this league are going to stop that bullet. My goodness, what a pass from Lidstrom along the ice and in a, oh my goodness, what a shot. I mean, it just jumped. It just sprung off his stick. Like trampoline effect with a driver.
Those first two games here against the Kings, and LA didn't look like they belonged on the ice with the Red Wings. And the Kings came back and swept in the next four. Here's Chelios. What a move. He's in. Shot. Stopped by Kucherov. He got the rebound, too. Here's Fedorov now. Picked off. This is a Vancouver power play. It looks like Detroit's the team with the van advantage. That's Daniel to Henry. And a penalty coming up. It was very good in the regular season. Steal by Shanahan. Nearly drew a penalty. Crowd wanted a call. And now a penalty is coming up. And Fedorov is going to go. Delayed call. One time shot. Stopped by Hasek. Rebound hit the post. And now we get the whistle. A wild sequence here in Detroit. 24 seconds, the two-man advantage. Chelios went down, crowd wanting a call. Eiserman down now as well. 5-on-3, off the Red Wings and in. Shot off Chris Chelios. Andrew Kessels from the angle. Chelios in frustration nearly broke his stick on the post. And we've got a 2-2 hockey game. Down low, Shanahan. Lidstrom, Shanahan rocking off the post. 3 seconds left in a 5-on-3. Shanahan shot. Stopped by Couturier. Letowski racing into the play. Another blocked shot by Lachance. It's a 5-on-4 for 48 seconds. Banked in off of Yui Koop.
Never hurts putting the puck on net.
Quick shot and a save. Here comes Naslin off the bench. Henrik Sedin hit by McCarty. Good forecheck. Duchesne's in deep now. Centering feet for Lariatov, and it's in! Might have got it off one of the cutouts, and it's going to count! It's 3-2 Detroit! Collision in the Vancouver crease leads to the goal.
And wasn't able to get it through to the goaltender, Dan Cloutier.
Maltby loses, turnover. Linden has Kessels. Kessels in. Great save by Hasek. Leading to his right, makes the blocker save. Maybe the Dominators' best save of the game. Well, the Red Wings had a 5-on-3 for over a minute.
Offside again.
Again, they call it onside. Very close. Here's Chubarov trying to knock it down in the midair. He's strong on his skates. Shot, they score! Trevor Linden and Artem Chubarov combining for the good pressure in the Detroit end of the quick shot out of nowhere. Beats Hasek, and we're tied at 3.
1-1, 3-on-1.
It's Bertuzzi. It's got Naslin and Morrison with him. Gets it across, and it's knocked into midair. Here's Jan Halavich. It's a 2-on-1 with Chubarov. Halavich. And I think it was partially blocked by the defenseman.
It was. Yuri Fisher.
Hasek was likely been instructed to stay in the net. Swings it around right to Kessels. Here's a chance. Bertuzzi's in. Great save by Hasek as he lost his stick. Oh. Dominic Hasek with the stick extended. And Eiserman wins it cleanly. They get the shot. It would have counted. Halavich, you might recall, was originally part of the Eric Lindros trade. Hard hit by Duchesne in front of that Red Wings bench. Pavel Datsyuk lets it go. Stick save. Couturier to the corner.
Oh, good hit by Datsyuk. Man.
Here's Cook. Cook is hit. Caught an elbow at center ice. Danilo came flying over. Headman pass. Shanahan's in. Backhand forehand. By Couturier. Nice poke by Bertuzzi to get it back to center. And Chelios lifts it up into the bench. And now Chelios and Bertuzzi are involved.
Not sure if he wants Bertuzzi falling on top of him, though. You got to get out of the way when you pull him down.
Not a 270 with equipment, as you pointed out earlier.
A bunch of lassos on the ice. There's lassos on the ice. You got the hooks, you got the holds. Lucci's been good.
Shanahan, Eiserman, turnaround shot, missed the mark as he lost his edge.
Oh, what a hit.
Chelios came in and pounded. 6:10 to go. This is sudden death. Our first overtime period from Detroit. Shot, score! Off an arm, I think, the side of Dominic Hasek. It was released by Henrik Sedin. And in sudden death overtime, the Canucks defeat the Red Wings 4-3.
Just put the puck on net and look at this enthusiastic Canucks squad put it on net. And that's exactly what Henrik Sedin did.
He cruises in front of the net. Igor Larionov outside the circle. With a minute left, power play time. Good enough for one time on the stop.
Look at this. He gets his stick caught in there. And he has to pull his shish kebab back out. Look. He says, geez, guys, if you want me to give you an autograph stick, could you wait till after the game? And this isn't exactly the first 10 minutes that the Red Wings would have hoped for.
Some speed. Chance for a two-on-one. Morrison offensive zone. Quick shot. Rebound. Loose. Bertuzzi scores! Todd Bertuzzi knocks it in! 1-0 Vancouver!
Well, as so often happens, you have a power play, and when the power play's not successful, you've got to be careful of the uprising of the defensive team and your letdown, and that's exactly what happened on this goal.
Trying to swing it through traffic along the inboards. Maslin trying to get through it as well. And Morrison stood up. Now Maslin with a 90 points. Regular season backhand try. Kick the side.
Vancouver in the lead on the shot clock, 5-4.
Play onside. Yzerman hit hard by Olin. And Stevie very slow to get up with the bad knee. Bertuzzi out of a long shift on the ice. He'll spin off, then go for a change. Morrison stays on there. Big chance on that rush. Canucks caught in a change. Chelios, offense's own Larionov, and there's Yzerman. Rebound, Chelios. What a stop by Pluche. Somehow it's kept out of the net. Still in the offensive zone. Holmstrom trying to track it down. Boy, is Yzerman slow to get up. He is hobbled.
What an opportunity that was, and Chris Chelios put it right off the pad of Kluche.
And like Chabarov, another young Russian player, they love his talent. Big shot, fill up, love down, Kluche, what a save. And Jovanovski, here to the blue line for Mark Crawford's team. Here's the captain, Yzerman, takes it right back to Detroit. Offensive zone, trying to create a shot. Chelios in room, pad stop made, rebound was loose in the slot, and no one could get there for the Wings. Penalty coming up.
Guy that's good at drawing penalties finally takes one, Kirk Maltby. Knocks Helmer into the open gate of the Detroit bench. Knocking the Helmer helmet right off. And let's take a look at Todd Bertuzzi. Look at this machine. Down he knocks over Duchesne. Watch this. Down goes another pin. Here he goes again. And down you'll go too if you don't watch out, Chelly.
Intercepted by Yzerman. Short-handed. Offensive zone. Tipped away last second by Maslin. Regained. Big shot from Fisher. It goes airborne for a second. 18 seconds of counting power play time. Here for Vancouver. Yzerman playing on one good leg. What an effort. Not exactly a lot of offensive production for their goaltender, Dan Kluche, but they still are protecting the 1-0 lead. Here is Brett Hull. Shots in the second period. All Detroit. Let me try to change that. Blocked away. Out for Jovanovski. Getting things set up. Loose down low. Deflected home! Castles in the low slot. Gets a piece of it on the way through. It's 2-0 Canucks.
Well, believe it or not, the most important guy on this goal is Dan Kluche. And the reason is all those graphics we've been showing you. They've only generated two shots before this goal since they scored their first goal. Down to our left in a big luxury box. And his name is Mike Yellich.
Barron's shot. Trouble again from Hasha because he covers up deep in his zone. The crowd face-off and a sarcastic cheer from the crowd.
Yeah, the sarcastic crowd.
2-4 for 6 points that year. Jabarov takes it back. Here's Cook near side. Big shot. And a pass stop made by Hasha. Regained though by Letowski. Sets up Jabarov. One-timer. Hasha lost sight of it. Centered again, but knocked down by Krug. Hasha out of sorts. No question in the Wings. Goal. Oh, the fans are letting him have it. Very hockey savvy.
They're on this whole team, though, Dave. They're on the whole Detroit team.
Keep in mind, goaltender Dan Kluche, Vancouver was never a starter until this year. Traded from Tampa Bay. You mentioned his origin with your team, the New York Rangers. Drafted in the early 90s. What a brilliant season he's had, setting all sorts of Vancouver records and personal career highs. Malpe takes it back, a big shot. Pad stop Kluche well out of the goal, shutting down the angle.
Now, I don't know if you could hear that on TV, folks, but this crowd was in unison chanting, shoot the puck. Shoot the puck, reminding me of the old days of the Garden.
Yzerman backhand try, slides it wide. Regain Chelios. On your board, sends it through, no one there. Tatsuka drive. And also, this is the net. A chance trying to bank it out of the zone. Cannot. Held in by Lidstrom. Jovanovski some time. Taken back by Hull. He'll try to center off. A stick of a chance, though. Jovanovski near the corner. Chelios holds in his own. The captain Yzerman on one good leg. And Vancouver sensing
with Pepper into the goal, rifles it down ice, but it's on net, no icing as Hasek's got to play it. Dotson some speed. Here's Eisenman. Right circle. Little time. Stevie spins out. Mitchell shot. Score! Watch this back pass. Stevie goes in. He's got nowhere to go, so he turns. He doesn't even know. He sends it back to Lidstrom, and it's, I don't think that was touched by Brett Hull, but it goes right over the stick glove. Dan Glucci, and it's 2-1, and that was the 15th shot on net by Detroit.
Lost the handle. Ship free by Robitaille. He's bumped off the puck. Big play by Helmer. Minor league journeyman most of his career. First ever NHL playoff game in game one. Is he ever excited talking about it today? It was a minus two, but still, that first career game is big. Back in the lineup again tonight. A chance at the point. His shot, score! More traffic in front and another Canucks goal!
And oh my goodness, is this crowd going to get down on Dominic Hasek? That man right there who's got more accolades. Scotty LaChance moves in and takes a shot that looked pretty ordinary when he wound up. But that traffic in front of the net, you're right, Dave, made it elude Dominic Hasek. Let's take a look at the traffic. Goes right through there. It looked to me like he could see it.
Paul trying to put up some big numbers. But back up that clout. Eisenman tripped up by Barron, no call. Try to center, it was broken up. Chelios, finishing. Throwing it around on that puck, loose, rebound down low. Cloutier has got it.
But boy, oh boy, this guy plays as well on one leg as 90% of the league plays on two. And tonight, it's a gutsy performance for the captain. They weren't sure if he was going to play here.
Each team will hop on their charter flights after the game and fly out to British Columbia as soon as it's over tonight. Fedorov offensive zone trying to get loose. Shanahan on the ball. Not in. Post. Hit the post again. The fans celebrating. I thought he had a goal. Talk about being snake bit. Fedorov trying to jam it in. Got Robitaille in front. Fedorov a great effort. In the far circle. He's loose. Shot stopped by Kucherov. Shot down again. Vancouver has got to be thinking about a long run now. They stretch this series out. Lots of action. Jovanovski's going to take a penalty. Can't believe it. In game one, Trevor and I talked about that very thing this morning after their skate. We broke down game tape. Trevor usually feels very good about a right-handed face-off against a right-hander, the way that matchup has gone in this series, but Eisenman's had the better of it. He said because he's lower down on the ground, he's got that base that hurt him. Eisenman, sharp angle, walks in, scores! Goal and an assist, playing on essentially one leg. He is badly injured because of the knee, gutting out an incredible performance tonight. Even before the goal, he had played so well.
But Detroit has to build on this momentum they got now in the building. They've got to give to him now, obviously, and tie this thing up.
Fedorov slammed into the boards in the near corner. With a puck on the line. Cook coming through, breaks in, sends it wide. What a chance! Out comes Eisenman again. Offensive zone, Robitaille just beyond his reach. He catches up with it. Sends to Larionov. Roland gets there first. Tripped up by Igor Larionov and regains his footing. Puck loose down low. Long enough for Robitaille. Stopped by Cloutier. And get an outstanding chance to tie it up. What a check, Eisenman and Roland. Can Steve Eisenman play any well? More effectively tonight.
Here's a chance.
Bertuzzi some room. Lidstrom back. Bertuzzi trying to make the move. And a pad stop by Hasek. Shuts down Todd Bertuzzi. Larionov for the red line. Stood up. Chabarov got hit by his idol, Igor Larionov. That doesn't feel good. Across the line, Letowski some room. A shot. And a stop made.
Well, a few minutes ago, our Southwest Airlines goal cam caught the Luke Robitaille scoring opportunity right there where they could have made it 3-3. Right after that, the Warriors beat Eisenman. Hits Matthias Norland. I almost said Nordstrom. Matthias Norland almost into next week, and that's a hit on one leg. We've been talking about it all night, but folks, this is a special performance by a very special player.
He defines Warrior.
What else can you say about Steve Eisman?
In the offensive zone, Bertuzzi takes it back. Leaves for Morrison. Brendan Morrison across the line. Room. Here's Naslund. Snapshot. Score!
What a shot!
What a shot by the captain, Marcus Naslund! 4-2 Vancouver!
What an incredible shot by Marcus Naslund. The whole way the Canucks came up the ice, Bertuzzi started off. He gave a nice, easy little back pass. And Marcus Naslund, and now you find out what a pure goal scorer is. What a rip. I'll tell you, this Joe Louis Arena is emptying out quicker than a fire drill.
Hasek out again, empty net. Quick shot put right on. Knocked down by Cook. Chelios a blast. Tipped wide. Comes down by a pair, need one immediately. It's an empty net. Matt Cook takes his time, looks it over, and scores! This one is over from Hockey Town. Vancouver is going to go back home up 2-0 against the top-seeded Red Wings and Scotty Bowman. What a story in this year's NHL playoffs.
How about Detroit and the gimpy Steve Yzerman, who has overcome his injury issues with the knee to have a spectacular game. What does he say to his teammates? What does Scotty Bowman say to the Wings and your friend Ken Holland, the GM here in Detroit? Games 3 and 4 in this series, and the final seconds expire in Vancouver Sunday and Tuesday. And if you listen hard enough, you can hear hockey fans from British Columbia screaming in joy because their Canucks lead the mighty Detroit Red Wings 2-0 in the Western Conference best of 7 quarterfinal series.
And Nick Lidstrom has it now for Fedorov. Fedorov with the neutral zone fires it right in on Couturier. Who hands it for Olin, intercepted by McCarty, a wraparound, and Couturier just got the right pad up against the post. Trevor Letowski, Chamara. Asha got the plate around the board. Demereau was there. With a hit on Datsyuk. Greatly increased his ice time in the first 2 games versus the regular season, and there's a in the postseason. Here is Datsyuk for Hall. Datsyuk got Zane Couturier. Now Letowski. Letowski, wraparound attempt blocked by Yuri Fischer. Letowski tries it the other way, and Hasek has it covered. As Brendan Shanahan looking for his first goal of these playoffs. Sends it across for Eisen. Puts on the brakes. Eisen in center back. Fischer trying to get it in front of Shanahan. And it didn't get through. Here is Fedorov with it. Hit shot, Zane Couturier. It's set around the board by the Canucks defense. They're taking the line for it. He makes the move on Brendan Morrison. Morrison by Morrison. Hits it down. Fedorov let the shot go. The play continues. Wings get the extra tackle on the ice. Now the Wings have tried to carry it in. They weren't successful. They tried to dump it in and they weren't successful. Here is Yzerman. He will carry it. He hands it off on the far side at the point, Duchesne. Now it goes in deep for Yzerman. Yzerman wraparound move. Couturier down. They score. A power play goal, and again it's Yzerman. And Couturier right away complaining that he may have been interfered with, but the goal will stand, and Detroit has taken a 1-0 lead.
And it is fitting, it is more than fitting, that the captain, Stevie Yzerman, score the goal. The best player on the ice for the Red Wings in game 2.
It is taken by Chamara. Chamara, they're going to go wide on Fischer. Fischer reaches, misses the puck. Chamara still has it. Wheels puts it to the crease. Made by Hasek.
Yzerman's going to take a bump here. All right, not much. He's down. Now watch the difficulty he has getting up. See, he's got to use his arm strength. Gets to the knee. You can see the grimace in the face. So there's a player, folks, like a lot of the players in the National Hockey League this time of year, and they simply gut it out. Only Steve Yzerman knows the pain that he is playing through, but I'm telling you, folks, it's more than most people at home could go to work with, never mind put on the uniform and skate and accept some of the physical punishment that these guys accept throughout a playoff series.
Ulster backhand flip wide of Couturier. Ulster takes it down. He and Cooper both go to the ice. Centering pass to Mount Cooper with a drive. Safe rebound. Luke Couturier trying to get it, and he does. As the Detroit player was shoved right over the top of Dan Couturier. And I think it was Murray Barron that had given the Detroit player the shove. And it may have been Malpe, who had gone off earlier, wincing after a Todd Bertuzzi hit.
Kirk Malpe right in the thick of things. One thing the Red Wings have to do. Any team, when you're playing against a hot goaltender, you have to get people in front of them. You need traffic.
He's
shot kicked into the circle. And a quick shot there by Maltby and the save by Cloutier. And Maltby takes a couple of punches to the face from Jovanovski. And
that's got to hurt.
Yeah, he's saying, well, okay.
Why is that not a penalty?
If that's not a penalty, that means I can hit him back, right?
I think you're better to skate away from Jovanovski.
Yeah. And then they made them tough to play again.
And they scored some big goals.
And a penalty coming here against McCarty, I believe.
Like Andrew Castles, who is down on the ice right now in some pain. I'm like, well, no, it's Jovanovski. I'm not sure if it was that puck that hit him or if it was a confrontation in front of the net. But nonetheless, he's being medically tended to right now.
Well, the penalty's against Maltby.
Jovanovski seems all right. And Jovanovski is also making his way to the penalty box.
He's up in by the wing. Shanahan, one timer with Clark. He'll try it again. No, he goes to center off from this fire with a wide open net. They win this faceoff. Back to Shanahan. Drives the shot. Safe made. Rebound chance.
Oh!
Stopped by Cloutier. And Fedorov,
baby,
for the second time in this game, has an opportunity. The first one he misfired. This one, Cloutier stops it. And there's going to be a call here against Darren McCarty. Right after Detroit had scored a goal to take a 2-1 lead in game one, he took a very unnecessary penalty. Here comes Bertuzzi. For the puck. Todd Bertuzzi! Just like that, 4 seconds into the power play has tied the game.
Well, Scotty Bowman cannot be happy with the penalty that was taken by McCarty. Just too critical a situation. Put the puck towards the net. Bertuzzi made sure he roofed it right underneath the crossbar. Oh, kaboom, kaboom.
Here is Castle. He hands it off now and a standard pass as the net comes out to support it. It's going to go against the choke and he slides in the net.
I'll tell you what, I've never been hit by a truck before, but I'm sure it wouldn't feel much different than that blow that Todd Bertuzzi put on Chris Chelios behind the net.
That's it to Daniel Sedin. Trying to drive it out of front. Rebound chance. Hasek, I believe, stopped that.
Mixing around. Tough guy to coach against when he has that many options available to him.
Heisman checked on the play. Here's Fedorov to the loose puck. He's got Shanahan with him. Fedorov to the forehand. Oh, baby. Play. He was just hooked on the arm, but Cloutier still had to make a save.
Sergei Fedorov has had three golden opportunities to score a goal in tonight's hockey game.
And they're back working hard. They're not just back standing around, but reducing a lot of the passing lanes as the Detroit Red Wings are trying to pass the puck through, making the interception. One of these times they make the interception, it's going to be a good counterattack and perhaps an odd man rush against the Wings.
Now Lindstrom to center right.
Baby!
Skip past Cloutier in the first chink in the armor of the Vancouver goaltender. Lindstrom looked like he was going to dump this in along the boards, although as I looked to Cloutier, he did not vacate the crease, so I don't think that part fooled him. This puck may have skipped.
It either skipped or dropped. Tough for us to tell from where we are sitting, folks. We might get a better look in the replay. This is as harmless a play as you can have. Center ice, the puck comes in, and I think it just eludes Cloutier. It looks like he goes to catch it. Lindstrom. Right at center ice, folks. Stuffing it in, we'll dump it in on net. There'll be a rebound. We can get a forecheck established here. And that just goes right through the glove hand of Dan Cloutier.
Good luck on home ice, as you see. This is being their last 9 home playoff games. Detroit Red Wings have lost 6 straight playoff games. 4 straight to LA last year. And Shanahan scores! Walked off the boards and snapped it by Cloutier. And so the pucks that Dan Cloutier was stopping in the first 2 games of the series, now a couple have gotten by, and the Red Wings have a 2-goal lead.
Some hard work by Stevie Yzerman, Sergei Fedorov along the boards, digging and digging for the puck.
Here is Nazem trying to center it. It's underneath Chelios, and he pushes it to the corner.
before he can be called for a delay of game. Joe Vanoski, good job to hold it in. Bertuzzi for Nassau. It's only one option. That's the ball up in game 1-2-3. Bertuzzi trying to get around Lipson. Lipson playing the angle. Look at Bertuzzi. He's one arm. Straight to Lipson. Makes the save. Saying he's grabbing my jersey with that hand. That's got to be a penalty. Morrison with a shot. Save. Oh,
maybe. No question. Best save of the series.
Is it too early to say the Dominator is back? 4.5 minutes to go in the third period. Maybe a little too early. This one isn't over yet. But this is typical Dominic Hasek hockey when you end up saying, how in the world did he make that save?
Here, 2-goal lead late in the game. Scotty Bowman, great confidence.
Good pass to Bertuzzi. He's outside.
Bertuzzi right here, he is in. He is
in the clear.
Yeah, he's in the clear. Lidstrom hooking him, catches up. Bertuzzi does not get the shot on the net. It's a weak shot wide. And Steve Wacom, the official, once again showing pretty good courage and character.
One on one. Bertuzzi has the only goal so far tonight. And he has one.
Well, could Dominic Hasek have had a better response to games 1 and 2 than game 3? Over 5 minutes of Vancouver power play time after they had scored a power play goal. A penalty shot by the best goal scorer wearing a white sweater tonight.
That's going to come out. Wait for Joe Vanoski tied up. Bertuzzi running to the boards there by Malkin. And then Bertuzzi throws a punch. He's going to throw another one. Here comes McCarty. He grabbed a hold of Bertuzzi, and that's Darren McCarty's job.
Well, we'll have to wait to see what the call is here. Bertuzzi for sure is going to get at least two. Whether Maltby has to go or not, we'll wait and see what the referees decide. And this game, I think, was won when the Vancouver Canucks failed to capitalize, David, on 5 minutes of power play after Bertuzzi had tied the game with a power play goal. They had a 5-on-3 opportunity. Dominic Hasek found himself.
Hook picks it up. Now it slides to Lindgren right on. And the rebound hop over the stick of Chubarov. Olsson hit by Naslin. Lidstrom plays him around. Holmstrom couldn't get it by Big Jovanovski. And now Lidstrom picks off the pass. It's a 3-on-1. Mariano Rubatai. And he shot it high for the first odd man opportunity. Well, the Canucks were caught, but got away with it. And now they'll turn it back again. Holmstrom, he's knocked down by Lachance and grabs the stick out of the hand of Lachance. There's Cook. He's nailed by Duchesne. They will match up apparently against Yzerman, Fedorov, and Shanahan in game 3. It was big line against big line. Roland in his own zone. At the point, Fisher shot, and they score! Kluche gets a piece, but Fisher with the shot that may have been tipped.
Is exactly what Vancouver Canucks didn't need, and Kluche included. After all the momentum that they built here early in this hockey game, the shot here, now this touches Sopel's stick and changes direction right in front of Dan Kluche.
Now back they come, Castles into Detroit territory. Bad angle shot, has to turn, he thought it was behind him. Into Vancouver territory, Holwood. 12 shots in the series, and yet to beat Kluche. Big hit by Linden on Draper. Oh, he's stapled to the boards by Barron. And a penalty coming up as Stephen Wacom will make the first call of the game at the 8:26 mark of this period. Better off nailed by Olin. Here's Duchesne. Hits center. Fires it in. Sopel jostling on the other side with Holmstrom. And the Canucks come up with it. Jovanovski with a move. Lost it. Hook sprawling. Kept in Duchesne. Dangerous play by Jovanovski. Maybe a chance for Detroit. Chelios gets it deep. Yzerman behind the net. Works against Sopel. Spun out by Shanahan. Chelios shot. Scores. A power play goal. gets by Kluche. And this one goes straight in. Straight in for Chris Chelios. And Kluche gets in trouble early on this play by not stopping the puck behind the net.
Warner in back of the net. Bertuzzi. Hot shot. Blocker stop. Bertuzzi in front. And he rolled it wide. Just missed the far post. Hatchet with another stick. It's centered in front. And it didn't get to Bertuzzi.
That had to smart.
Now Fedorov swings it to Yzerman. Oh, off the bar. Steve Yzerman. Off the crossbar. Maybe the first break the Canucks have had in the period. Haslam back in. Bertuzzi on the attack. In. Oh, he just shot wide. Hashik down. Lost his stick again. And a penalty coming up against the Canucks. Bertuzzi out of the box. Here's a break with Chubarov. Chubarov can't get it back to Bertuzzi. Where is it? It's up into the glove of Lindstrom. In the paraphernalia. Bertuzzi trying to come out in front. A shot right on. Helmer steps up. And Helmer keep it in. Naslin. Bertuzzi fires it right on from a bad angle. They can't clear. Time winding down. Naslin. Helmer. Shot. Gloved by Hatchik. And a delayed penalty coming up. Now Castles clumps it down. Takes control. Great pass. Bertuzzi in. Shot. Hatchik the save. Check that Warner. Now Linden has it. Back to Olin. Shot through. And that went right through Hatchik. Olin. Naslin. Shot. Right on. Loose. And Hatchik pounced on that rebound.
Chelios always looks at the ref first to see where he is before he does any damage. And this time it's actually Bertuzzi that gets tied up with Chelios. And there's the extra shot. But did you see Chelios look for the ref first? He's a master at doing that. Chris, I'm a little surprised that Vancouver have not picked on Yzerman yet and nailed him a couple times to test his knee.
Letowski, a bad angle shot. Letowski's got it again in front. It's gone! Matthias Holland! Are 16-6 in favor of the Canucks. Here comes Jovanovski and Hatchik, and Jovanovski bumping in, and he'll go off. Draw some extra attention before he heads to the box.
Another dive by Hatchik. I gave it to him for doing it earlier in the period. This time it worked, so maybe I shouldn't have. However, Jovanovski did take a whack and make contact.
Here's Hull hanging on, looking. The one-timer stopped by Kluche. Lost it. Datsyuk in front. Devereaux missed. A pass right across the goal mouth by Hull. And countering now Letowski. Letowski in the middle. Castles tried to get it for Cook. Datsyuk run over by Cook. Olsson's up now. He's nailed by Daniel Sedin. Sopel watching Holmstrom. Robitaille's got the loose puck. He's nailed again, but stays on it. Luke Robitaille. Check there by Kluche.
All of a sudden, they just come at you in waves. Here they come again.
Shanahan ahead. Yzerman. Fedorov. And a big stop by Kluche there. Chubarov behind the net. He's hit by Dandino and knocked down.
Official says it's a penalty.
Now they come up with it. Bertuzzi. Lindstrom pried it loose. And away go the Red Wings on a 2-on-1. Olin Yzerman. In front. Naslin. Jovanovski firing it. Blocked Yzerman. Naslin. Hatchik down. And they pile up. And Bertuzzi knocked down in front by Dandino.
Hatchik just lies down in the crease. And this puck is sitting there.
10 seconds left in the power play. Face off one by Vancouver. Olin tees it up and fires off Cook wide of the net.
face, and now Letoski in front of the Detroit bench with a shove for Draper. And what a night Matt Cook has had stirring things up. As has Olin, who lost it here in front. Down, Yzerman scores! Somehow Steve Yzerman rolled it in, and Detroit regains the lead on a record big breaking goal by Steve Yzerman. Steve Yzerman now with 7 points in the series, and he's the all-time Red Wing playoff scorer, moving ahead of Mr. Hockey. Off a leg into the corner. Around the boards. It gets back to Jovanovski. The shot. Bertuzzi pulls over the netminder. Maybe Yzerman out there to settle the youngster Datsyuk. While Scotty Bowman wants to continue with four lines. Castles. He'll dump it in. Letoski on the forecheck. Along with Cook. Out in front. And it's tipped past Sokol. Down the ice. A race for it. And Kluche out. The collision with the goaltender.
And Kluche at the moment, I am sure, does not know where he is.
He got his bell rung, his mask is off, and he's down.
Dandino in the box. Kluche shakes it off. Peter Skudra in the backup. Chubara, his shot knocked down, and Yzerman knocked over. Slow to get up after that one. Steve Yzerman, in his 71st game against the Vancouver Canucks, has 89 points.
As the two of them meet up, here comes Chelios, and watch this. Chat, face wash by each. That's enough, boys, and they break it up.
Matthias Olin have a goal and an assist each. Warner testing Hodgick, who thought about clearing, and then covered, and Daniel Sedin sent McCarty tumbling over the Detroit netminder. Cooks on the ice with Letoski and Morrison. Chelios upending Letoski. Chelios wanted a diving call there. And now we're going to get a penalty. Fisher's going off.
It's almost like you embarrass me and I'm going to get you back.
As he is perhaps watching more anxious. Draper breakaway. Chris Draper in. And stopped by Kluche. Oh, that could have been it. 5 minutes to go. Kluche, an enormous save. Off Chris Draper, vying for the shorthanded goal. Chelios nails Bertuzzi. And a Red Wings clear again. And Bertuzzi to the attack with Castles. Through, and it's just too far for Castles. Put down on Chelios. And to the number one, is that way uncalled. Back for Larry Otto.
Hasek does not control this rebound. That sets up the chance. And Vancouver had one shot there, but Nicholas Lindstrom does a terrific job in Chubara.
Morrison back between Naslin and Bertuzzi, who actually is lined up where Jovanovski usually is.
Way over here, Bertuzzi. There he is.
There's the set play, and they get it to Bertuzzi quickly in. Off the back of the net. Out comes Kluche, extra attacker on. Chelios trying to clear it, kept in by Castles. The man off the bench. But McCarty gets it down. Draper, open net, scores! And he crashes into the net after the insurance goal in the final minute. Back down ice for a moment. It looked like Bertuzzi and Chelios were going to go. Well, that's why everybody sprinted to center.
Game. Just a terrific game. And now the fans are throwing stuff on the ice, and this isn't any good at all.
Thursday night, they'll break the tie as the Red Wings have fought back to win two straight in Vancouver.
I wanted to do today was talk about the officiating in this series to this point in time.
I want to point out to the officials that Todd Bertuzzi does not play for Detroit. It just looks like that because he's wearing two or three red sweaters all the time. I didn't know that tackling was an acceptable tactic. I didn't see it in our rule book. Sedin is not English for punch me or headlock me in a scrum. Our goaltender can be identified by the large pads and the mask that he wears. He's also the goaltender on the ice that does not dive when he gets brushed.
Detroit has 12 captains and assistants to speak to the officials. We find that unusual. Most teams have only two or three.
Detroit Red Wings, no changes primarily in their lineup tonight, as you would expect. Back on the odd man, Rush Lidstrom looking into the middle, centering pass, Megan Shanahan looking. The in shot and a save made. Big early save, and guess who? Steve Yzerman coming off the bench, wide open in the middle. And it's going to be on the Vancouver Canucks. A roughing call picked up by Todd Warner.
The Detroit Red Wings have the momentum in this series.
Power play for Detroit, a chance for them to go up early in this game. Centering pass deflected in the air to the near side. Brendan Shanahan battling in the corner. Helped hold it in. Tomas Holmstrom working behind the net. Will go out on front to set the screen. Shanahan in. Shot. Holmstrom deflected. Cloutier there. Shanahan again. A lot of room. Shot. Save made by Cloutier. Rebound, score! Sergei Fedorov, 1-0 Detroit.
Well, the Detroit Red Wings left the Joe Louis Arena down two games to Vancouver, and they left this building to a chorus of boos. They come back as heroes. They take a 1-0 lead here.
Centering pass for Linden. Linden turning it back along the wall. Jovanovski a shot. Save. Rebound. Hasek. Big time two save. Dominic Hasek.
Oh. Oh, my.
Rebound sent to Fedorov at center. Sergei Fedorov moving. One on two. Fedorov will turn. Yzerman cutting to the net. Fedorov a shot. Cloutier knocked it away. Cloutier is having a good start, but a tough one. He's really being tested.
Ooh.
He went for a trip there on Brett Hull. Sergei Fedorov's blast from the point. Tattoos in your head, Danny.
Played around the near side wall. Matthew Dandino. Ooh, mercy. What a shot put on by Matt Cook. Reunited line. Chelios a chance. Ooh. Right through the legs. I know a lot of hockey people would pay, at least twice that amount for Scotty's head. Back in behind the net. Center trying to get it tied, and another big save. Dominic Hasek high off the glass. Far side point, Andrew Castle shot. Hasek again. Bertuzzi trying to jam it home. Hasek didn't like it.
Hasek is stuck in this jam up. He's trying to get away from it. What a mountain of a man Todd Bertuzzi is.
3-1 and 4-2. Power play over, one shot. So they have back-to-back power plays and got a combined three shots and no goals. Detroit leading it 1-0. Backhand shot deflected into the corner. Good play by Malkin that time to block Lukowski's chance. Penalty coming up. Yuri Fisher's going to get it. Delayed call. Ryan Burks upstairs going. It worked. Into the corner. Still loose. Delayed call. Behind the net, Lukowski with their penalty killing in the tighter box. Naslin goes out onto the point. Olin there. His chance deflected. Open net, and Hasek got back. Dominic Hasek is really frustrating the Vancouver Canucks right now. Ruutu was over there and couldn't get it. Here's a 2-on-2 shorthanded. Fedorov up. Sergei Fedorov has got the goal dropped. Let's see. Score! It'll be a shorthanded goal. Matthew Dandino.
Fedorov has his dancing shoes on in this game. I don't think he's done yet picking up points. What a feed to Matthew Dandino. And it sure helps to have somebody with rocket boosters for skates in Dandino back on the blue line that can move up and make that play.
Here's Morrison, Vancouver. Drop pass. Naslin, that's going to be deflected off the blocker into the corner. Naslin's had a couple of chances in the game
this time of year, but you can count on great
break
performances.
Break into one save, rebound, score! 3-0! This is two kids and a goat, as named by Brett Hull, the name of the line. The kids changed, the goat didn't. They still score.
Well, the GOAT gets his first point of the playoffs, and that is Brett Hull. And that's more bad news for the Vancouver Canucks, because if Brett Hull starts feeling good about himself, you got a major problem. He needed a little bit of help on the coverage, and it wasn't there. Cloutier with the first save, Boyd Devereaux with the rebound, bingo. If Boyd Devereaux wasn't even in the lineup for the first couple of games in this series, finally Scotty Bowman reinserted him. And Brett Hull was a happy guy and is even happier now.
He replaced Pavel Datsyuk, and that is it for Dan Cloutier for the moment. The 25-year-old who has played all of the minutes in this playoff series so far is out of the game. Three goals against him on 9 shots. Scudry in. Big first period series for Detroit. 7-1 the advantage. Cleared around to Fisher by Chris Chelios. Bertuzzi moving over to try and hold it in. Bertuzzi had it knocked away. Topol could not hold it in. 2-on-1. Fedorov's on the right. Hull now 2-on-2 over to Fedorov. One-handed. Scored! Oh, what a tip! And Detroit making a mockery out of this one.
Two goals and one assist here in the first period for Sergei Fedorov. Peter Skudra, I think, was waiting for Sergei Fedorov to control this puck with two hands. I don't need two stinking hands. One's enough. Sergei Fedorov, amazing, as are the Red Wings so far.
That's Shanahan. Castles came away with it. Fisher came up with a hit. Good shot on Bertuzzi, who gets up slowly. That hurt. He caught him right in the back and bent him in two.
Well, Fisher's the only guy big enough on the Detroit roster that can actually take Todd Bertuzzi.
Morrison back on top to Olin on the one-timer. They've got to get one here, and they can't do it. Penalty's over. There's the hit. Right out of the box. That was Darren McCarty who came up, put a shot on Olin, and the puck went up ice. Sokol in the corner. Fans just on their feet for Darren McCarty, who came up firing.
This was called eating it up.
There he is again. Not a lot of shots here in this period. Detroit making sure on D and making sure they hit. Left is Fisher, put a shot on Bertuzzi and knocked him down. McCarty a chance, deflected. Back in behind the net. Red Wings look like they're skating even faster. Draper off a break-in shot. What a play! Skudry gave him nothing to shoot at. But he won't go too far from that net. He's been out a couple of times. He's out right now, and the puck rolls to the corner. And a penalty coming. It'll be on the Detroit Red Wings. There's an opportunity that goes by the board. Hasek was down and out. Frederick Olofsson locked up with a headlock. Power play Detroit, a minute 12 on it. Robitaille is set up in front. Their leading power play man takes the chance. Scudra to start with. And once they got behind so early, 4-0, they have not been able to get it back. And Detroit has not surrendered that step. This is the kind of stuff we thought we might see a little of. But even that is not happening for Vancouver to try and move it along. Coming, Bertuzzi in the middle. Pass to him, deflected back to Naslin. Naslin turning, takes the chance. No, save Hasek, and it's cleared up and over. Todd Warner. First time it was blocked, second time he tried to be too fine. Cleared up, Draper on the right side, brings it in onside. Draper to Duchesne, Duchesne a chance. Off the end of the glove of Peter Skudrun, wide. Eisen, better off, looking for the hat trick. Brought back to Eisenman. Open shot. Scooter the save. And I mean, he was open. That's two hit mass in this game.
You can hear him. And the sound was similar to the one that hit Cloutier.
Shanahan, a great setup over there on the tip.
The fans are hoping the next time they see these Red Wings won't be game 7 of this series, but game 1 of the next series.
Yep. 50 seconds left to go on it. 29-25 the shots. Penalty coming up. Scrum in front of the bench of Detroit. And that draws the whistle immediately. McCarty's going to go. And
Murray Barron was in there for Vancouver.
Oh, what a left from Darren McCarty.
That was a miscue by a Canuck. He tried to center it out front. He put it all the way down the ice.
Detroit looking for another one. Centering pass blocked to the corner. Warren had bounced it off the wall. Played up by Rutu. Down they go. Rutu taken out of the play. Wings just ragging it back here. 5 seconds left to go. The Red Wings 4, Vancouver nothing. Dominic Hart with his 7th playoff shutout.
A
major factor in the first period of this game when Vancouver was all stoked up with power play opportunities. But now the Vancouver Canucks, who hadn't lost consecutive games in a month, who have now lost three, the Detroit Red Wings, who hadn't won consecutive games in a month, have now won three straight in this series.
Knocked off his stick, following up his Castle. Sends it to the net, a save by Hasek. Gave up a rebound, but it's clear to the Wings. Come out, could have a three on two here as Holmstrom dumps it along the near boards. Jovanovski gets there just ahead of Larionov. Here's Holmstrom in on the forecheck. Loose puck in front of Kloupje, and a backhand shot. Step rebound, score! Larionov from his knees made this play, and Detroit scores just a minute and five into the first period.
Thomas Holmstrom has given the Red Wings a one-goal lead.
And you mentioned Holmstrom, second of these playoffs. He was given credit for the first goal the Red Wings scored in Game 5. It was originally announced as Fedorov's, as the Red Wings, including the goal that was just scored, have now outscored Vancouver 9-1 in this series in the first period of play. And it's recovered by the Wings to the line. Murray Barron unable to hold it in as he was challenged there by Robitaille, who drops it back for Dandino. Now Duchesne ahead for Holmstrom. Holmstrom sends it in deep. Cloutier comes out to play it. Here comes Robitaille. Puck comes free. Igor Larionov score! Larionov with an assist and now a goal. And Detroit leads it 2-0.
Well, it's the same trio for the Red Wings once again on the forecheck. Holmstrom in on the puck. Makes Cloutier hurry his pass. Mark Crawford is putting Peter Skudra in the net once again. And Cloutier will not finish a game against the Detroit Red Wings.
It might be a situation where Mark Crawford is just saying, if we're down two goals, we still have a lot of game left here, boys. I mean, you know, we're...
Here is Trevor Linden, speaking of a lot of game, getting a chance at Hasek. Here is Sofa with a shot into the glove of Hasek. He'll hold it there as Matt Cook and Fedorov come together, and the Canucks showing a little bit of tenacity, and Mick Magoo has spotted something. He's going to call one penalty for roughing. But in two other games, Detroit has blown one-goal lead, so they haven't necessarily done a great job protecting leads, with the exception, of course, of Game 5 when they scored four in the first period. Here is Naslin now. Naslin out near the line, hands it off for Jovanovski. He'll wrist it toward the net. Score! It may have been deflected, but a power play goal has cut the Detroit lead in half.
Defenseman Chris Chelios was in front of the net. So was big forward Todd Bertuzzi. And that puck may have been redirected. I don't know if it was Bertuzzi or it was Chelios trying to prevent the Jovanovski shot from getting to the net.
And don't forget, Dan Cloutier could come back in. It's not like a pitcher that goes out of a baseball game that can't come back. As the crowd appreciates the work of this line, with Todd Warner throwing a couple of big hits. He's the winger with the Sedin twins. And here comes a chance. Edmund Sedin, score! We've got a tie game!
And watch Sedin. He looks not only Duchesne off, but he looks Hasek off. That's a situation where Dominic Hasek has to play their shooter all the way. You can see Duchesne playing pass. There is no passing lane. Defenseman Steve Duchesne cut that down. Dominic was guessing a little bit. He should have had that post covered.
Lidstrom back to Shanahan. Shanahan to Fedorov, front of the net, and Holmstrom was there, and he is absolutely decked by Murray Barron. And another penalty coming. Boy, Detroit might want to give up the puck here to have more time with a two-man advantage, but they're going to take the shot that is blocked. And the penalty coming here against Murray Barron. I mean, he got 2 minutes worth, I'll tell you that.
Maybe.
It goes in deep. Larionov sends it back for Lidstrom. Lidstrom sends it across. One-timer, Eiserman saves Skudra. No rebound.
Maybe. What a good save by Peter Skudra.
Comes down to Brett Hull. 5 seconds on the 5-on-3. Hull with a shot. Oh, what did that hit?
Mask,
did that hit the mask? It did sound like it hit plastic, I'll tell you that. As Devereaux hands it off now for Chelios, and Hull drives it. Oh, Skudra just got a pad on it as that puck skipped.
Yeah, right in front of him.
Larionov hands it off to Hull. Snaps the shot. Skudra, the save. Rebound is there. Backhander. Skudra, another save. And the penalty to Letowski is over, and it bounces to center ice. This is offside. Letowski waits. Sends it in front. Save! Second save. And it's cleared to center ice, and a penalty coming here against Detroit. A delayed call.
And score only two goals.
Yeah, that's absolutely incredible. Lane, what a series.
Nassib, great move, gains the zone. Wrist shot, Hasek save, rebound, cleared by Chelios to the boards and hooked away by Draper. Draper, and a good job there by Joe Manoski. Draper still controlling, gets it in front of shot, good for save, oh, rebound, good by Murphy. Here is Lindstrom, he scores! Oh, what a sequence, a shorthanded goal, and Skudra is absolutely furious, as are his teammates. They feel he was interfered with.
Well, before he was interfered with, Draper grabbed Ed Jovanovski just inside the blue line and spun him. That's how Draper was able to get to the net, as GM Brian Burke looks on in disgust. And then Skudra was run into in the net. He could not recover. Mark Crawford is biding his time. I'm sure he's going to wait till the referees are close enough so they can hear his challenge. But Draper got away with one right there. There's Draper pulling Jovanovski down. Jovanovski can't recover. That's the first scoring chance. And then Draper runs into Skudra. Skudra's out of the net. And Lidstrom, with a wide open net, comes in and bangs it in. But the penalty should have been called before Draper even made it to the net. It's a one-on-one situation.
But without a stick, Steve Yzerman still trying to make a play. Bats the puck over, though, the Canucks control. Their power play continues. Here comes Linden trying to tie the game, and he just missed it on the outside of the post. And it's cleared, and here's a breakaway for Brett Hull, looking for his first goal of the series. He fakes, he gets it! Brett Hull off the post and in! Two shorthanded goals by Detroit on the same penalty.
Well, there's nothing for the Canucks to argue about on the Brett Hull goal, except poor coverage by their team. Brett Hull freezes, boom, boom, and from the wide angle, tings in off the goalpost.
Mariana bumped off the puck by Jovanovski. Hull taken down by Lachance. Oh, a turnover here, a chance in front. Oh, Skudra, what a save on Mariana. That could have been the game if it goes to a three-goal advantage with under 5 minutes to go in the second period. Remember that Skudra save. Well, the Vancouver Canucks players, we got a penalty coming away from the
That was Barron, yeah.
As Lepowski held his man up. Chelios again hearing it from the crowd here. Just over half a minute remaining in the Murray Barron penalty. Mariana feeds it now to Brett Hull. Hull snaps a shot, he scores! Brett Hull! Just inside the post. And Detroit has the three-goal lead. And obviously, Joanne, very happy.
Well, it's a deep hole with slippery sides right now. And what Brett Hull does on this shot is he changes the angle at release. The puck is well out from his body. He pulls it in towards the skates and then snaps it.
So the 240-year-old figuring prominently in this Detroit lead at this point. Now Chelios will wrap it around. Hull got a stick on it, but it goes right to Naslund. Naslund hands it off. Here's Lachance with a shot and a save made by Hasek. Chelios was down in the corner, but he gets back up. He's looking around.
Man, he's saying his head was pushed right into the glass. The nose is bleeding. The lip is bleeding.
Knocked away center ice. Here's Castles on the turnover. Drops it back. Jan Halavichuk. Oh, deflected off of Olsson. And a save made there by Hasek.
Well, things getting interesting here. 15 minutes to go. And it's a situation where both coaches try to break the third period down into quarters.
Here's Jovanovski into the zone with Henrik Sedin. Now it goes to Bertuzzi. In deep for Marcus Naslund. Back for Bertuzzi. He's got a stick on that.
Dominic doing a little bit of acting there. I think Bertuzzi had to stick up, but I don't think it was quite that much force on it. Looks like somebody shot Dominic from the stands the way he went down.
Here is Naslund, and a one-timer saved by Hasek, and he hangs on.
Well, he's getting up, and he's arguing, so perhaps there was a little more force to that Bertuzzi hit.
Well, Brian Burke, as part of his press conference earlier in the week, said the official should be able to recognize which goalie is the Vancouver goalie because he's the guy standing up with the pads on. Henrik Sedin, who has one of the two Vancouver goals. Here's Linden with a shot. Oh, he had some room on the far side, and he missed that post. Jason Williams getting set to come out of the box. Still 5 seconds on this power play. Jovanovski, a wrist shot. Loose goal! Oh, long in front by Henrik Sedin, his second goal of the game.
Don't leave your TV sets, folks. 13 minutes to go here in the third period. You're talking about the most explosive team in the National Hockey League, the Vancouver Canucks.
Good play by Draper to bump Drobel off the puck and then make sure the puck clears the blue line.
Haslett has bumped off the puck. The Canucks maintain possession. Now it's taken away. And
Oh, boy.
Checked by Bertuzzi just as he was following through on his dump in. Here's Fedorov. Oh, he saw the chance at the last second. Eisenman drives a shot. Scooch with a save, and he hangs on. Starts it back the other way. Oh, he had Draper in the seam there for a moment, but Olsson dumped it in the zone as Draper goes in for a hit, and then Draper is drilled.
The Red Wings seem content to get the puck deep and to sit on this two-goal lead. They really haven't taken many offensive chances.
But Duchesne getting back, but doing a good job on him.
Well, you often see a forward on the blue line on a Red Wing power play, but with a two-goal lead in the third period, Scotty electing to go with two defensemen.
Larionov looking for Hall, gets it to him, the shot's gone!
Baby!
That'll be the hat trick! Robitaille was there, and it bounced off of something, but I think it hit a Vancouver player. And Joanne is sure that that's the hat trick for her son.
Well, the gunpowder has dried. And Brett Hull has ignited the Red Wing hockey team here in this game. Brett Hull with the hat trick. And what does Mom Joanne think about that, Brett? Wow, absolutely right.
Red Wings on their way to advancing to the second round. Sopel, though, and the Canucks keep coming. Letowski now moving up. Jovanovski, it's knocked away. And it's taken now by Helmer. Helmer winds up, sends it to the corner. Letowski. Now it goes to Castles. Andrew Castles looking for somebody out in front. Here's Letowski, save, rebound, score! Matt Cook has made it 6-4.
Don't go away, folks, don't go away. Hasek makes the initial save. The rebound sits right in the slot.
And Draper unable to clear. Now it's slapped to Malpe, and he chucks it off the boards here. Draper with an open net, and he slides it in wide. It's not icing. Oh, and McCarty got a smart play at all. What is he thinking?
Well, especially when Draper got away with it, shorthanded pulling Jovanovski down. We've told you about that one all night long, folks, or since it occurred.
Detroit looking to advance to the second round. Oh, Hasek missed it. The Canucks, though, couldn't capitalize. He's back between the pipes as Vancouver gets control now for Naslin. One-timer, Helmery shot it high, missing it. Oh!
Baby.
And it just missed on the angle.
Oh, man.
Chris Chelios tries to clear. Matt Cook to Bertuzzi. Fedorov trying to stay on him. Bertuzzi tried to center. Trevor Linden was out there. And he was alone. Now,
what a move. Man.
And he backhands it over everybody's head down the ice.
What a hockey player. Under pressure, everybody coming to get him. The little fake stick handle, and then he clears the blue line. Stevie Y, you are my inspiration.
It comes back to Cook, knocked away. Eiserman going for the open net, and he fired it wide.
And the crowd showing great fan support here for their Vancouver Canucks. Whether it's a rallying cry with 19 seconds to go, I don't think so. I think it's just, we appreciate everything you've done for us this year, boys. Remember, at Christmas time, this team's 7 games below 500. From January 1st on, they had the best record in the National Hockey League, Dave, so they did everything they could do to get into these playoffs.
And the day after Christmas, Brian Burke had a meeting with the team, and he said, a lot's been made of this, and I don't take credit, but he said, I went in the room and talked to the guys about what we had done the year before when we were so good, what we were doing wrong in the first half of this season, and he said, if you guys get it turned around, I'm going to leave this team alone, keep the players together, as that shot nearly got all the way through to Hasek. And the players did respond. And there were a lot of teams that were battling for those final playoff spots, including the Edmonton Oilers, who didn't get in. Centering pass right through the goal mouth that comes to Helmer, and that's going to do it. The Detroit Red Wings with a 6-4 win here in Game 6, win the series 4-2.
Great credit to the Vancouver Canucks. Great team effort. Good job by their coaching staff and GM Brian Burke. And good luck to the Red Wings as they move on in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
They'll have to wait for Monday's Game 7. If L.A. wins it, Detroit will play L.A. San Jose will play St. Louis. If Colorado wins that game, Detroit gets St. Louis in the next round. San Jose gets Colorado. So you can't prepare for a specific opponent, but I'm sure the one thing that the Detroit Red Wings are happy about, as you pointed out, Jim, that they aren't playing a Game 7.
Oh, absolutely.
And they get a few extra days rest.
Look at the big turn. He's taking again. Giving it to the fans here in Vancouver.
Every second of it.
Look at him. Four assists tonight.
Yeah.
He's loving it.
Is he ever basking in it?
Boo me when you can. I'll cheer you now. Beautiful.